Greeting, my name is Aida Nazira binti Zulkifli. The title of my final year project is Plastic Waste Mapping and Monitoring using Geospatial Approach. The content of my presentation comprises introduction, literature review, methodology, result and discussion, as well as conclusion and recommendation. For background, plastic use worldwide and worsen the condition when it is dumped into the river and streams. Plastic waste entering the ocean is estimated 90% to come from river. Malaysia ranks second highest in total waste production in terms of plastic waste. Geospatial information is an urgent need to mitigate and raise awareness about plastic footprint. Therefore, GIS plastic leakage concentration investigation is necessary to identify areas that need to minimize plastic leakage. The problem of this study is the challenge of waste management is growing as society uses increasing number of plastic material, and many of them are only used once or used for a short period. Plastic will have significant impact on the environment and economy once it dumped into the ocean. The challenge is to achieve the optimal collection and transport of waste. The solution for this problem can be solved as GIS is recognized as one of the latest innovations that have contributed to the waste management community in less time. Purpose of recycle bin for the required areas and proper allocation of waste bin, and finally determine the sufficient plastic waste collection route to nearest plastic recycling center or landfill. This study aims to improve waste management at the catchment area to prevent plastic waste emission and leakage to the marine environment in the urban area. The objective of this study is to observe the plastic waste at specific point using digital tool. Second, to determine the hotspot location of waste of plastic waste deposit in the study area. And finally, to identify the efficient collection route for plastic waste in the study area. As reviewed by Emery and Swartz, the plastic in the river system depends heavily on three processes, which are transport, accumulation, and degradation. The harm of plastic debris is classified into five categories, which are ingestion of plastic, entanglement in plastic, leakage of toxic additive and accumulation of toxin, breakdown in microplastic and human livelihood. The method used for monitoring to date can be approximately separated into five different methods, which are plastic tracking, active sampling, passive sampling, visual observation, and citizen science. For plastic hotspot mapping, a study by Chen et al. Used different mapping techniques to identify hotspots of plastic, including point mapping, thematic mapping, spatial ellipse, grid thematic mapping, and kernel density estimation. For road collection mapping, a review by O'Connor used network and risk extension to reduce the overall cost of waste collection and transportation in Redland, California. Let us move to the methodology. Firstly, selecting the study area, then collect data of plastic waste using plastic tracking method by using local smart application. After done with the data collection, proceed with the analysis for hotspot location and route collection by using QGIS software. The study requires the use of QGIS software to perform the analysis. Next, local smart application is used for plastic tracking. Today, data collection via mobile device is the most widely used method for all cases. The mobile device must consist of a working camera and GPS with internet connection. Plastic waste for this study required to be measured using measurement scale to input in the local smart application that we use later in the QGIS software. The study area is chosen based on the current plastic waste at the catchment area in the urban area. Sungai Pinang is one of Malaysia's most polluted rivers located at the northeast of Penang Island. The river stretch is approximately 3.1 km. It will observe from two sides. Although the length is only 3.1 km, it is full of garbage caused by human activity across the river. This chart shows the process of data collection. For the first step, find plastic waste, and second step, take photo, and finally input dimension in the local smart application. Three different mapping techniques is used to identify hotspot of plastic, including point mapping, kernel density estimation, and standard deviational ellipse using UIL method and crime start method. For the route analysis, the operation involves the removal and transfer of plastic waste from the assembly point to the one available landfill in Pulau Pinang, namely Pulau Burung Sanitary Landfill, which is located at Nibu Tebal. Proper allocation of dustbin is proposed at the study area. The distance between two bins should not exceed 500 meters. The figure at the right side shows the dustbin placement at the Sungai Pinang. Proceed with result and discussion. The first figure shows the plastic waste data collected using local smart application along the river stretch. And the second figure shows some of plastic waste photo taken using the local smart application. As we can see, measurement scale is put next to the plastic waste to measure the dimension. This slide presents the hotspot map produced using QGIS software. Figure A is the point mapping. B is the kernel density estimation map. C is standard deviational ellipse using UIL method, and D the standard deviational ellipse using crime start method. The analysis of where plastic waste takes place is the key component to tackle plastic waste problem. Each technique identifies similar area, but in terms of predictive features, spatial pattern of plastic waste,
KDE was better at defining hotspot and predicting where future plastic waste may occur. The hotspot was found approximately in the middle of the river's branch. The hotspot is observed to be related to the residential and recreational area along the river. Fewer plastic hotspots were discovered at the factory and forest area, but quite high concentrated at the southeast and northwest of the river. Continuing with route analysis, the left figure is the shortest route of waste collection and transportation from the allocated waste bin to the sanitary landfill using the QGIS tool, which is network analysis. Meanwhile, the right figure is the faster route that has been generated using the same QGIS tool. The collection time for the shortest and faster route from the allocated bins at Sungai Pinang to the Pulau Burung sanitary landfill were 2.355 and 1.366 hours respectively, with total distance of 57.854 km for the shortest route, while 67.621 km for fastest route. Based on this table, we can see the shortest path is not necessarily having the shortest time to travel. To conclusion, plastic data tracking method using Citizen's Find application is a great value for riverine and marine plastic study. Analysis of where plastic waste takes place is the key component to tackle plastic waste problem. By using QGIS, the most efficient route has been determined. The collector can use their preferred route, either the fastest route or shortest route. The development of GIS and its use throughout the world has contributed a lot in improving waste management system. Recommendation for future studies. Firstly, it is suggested to use of UAVs or boat to track plastic waste at the unreachable location. Second, conduct regular observation to predict where plastic waste will occur in the future. Hence, it will use large-scale approach and it will get more accurate data. And finally, route of waste collection is good to review every 1 to 2 years depending on the growth of the service area and enforcement. That's all from me. Thank you.